Nutrient pollution is one of the most widespread, costly, and challenging environmental problems in America today. Excess amounts of nutrients can lead to algal blooms and shorelines clogged with seaweed. This results in lost fish and shellfish habitat. The waters of Cape Cod, Massachusetts are increasingly nutrient impaired, largely from excess nitrogen in wastewater and stormwater.
Studies tell us that nitrogen reductions are necessary across the Cape in order to ensure that we have clean water to support our fish and shellfish habitat, and also in order to support recreational uses such as swimming, boating, and fishing that Cape Cod is known for.
EPA, the State of Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection, the Cape Cod Commission, and community partners on the Cape are working together to address these issues. Two towns on Cape Cod were selected to receive technical assistance from EPA to pilot innovative green infrastructure, best management practice, or BMP retrofits designed to capture and treat nitrogen in stormwater.
So the town of Chatham proposed this BMP to EPA a number of years ago for one very good reason. Right down the street is what's known as Oyster Pond. And we've identified water quality issues here a number of years ago. These first being bacterial contamination, because the pond is used extensively for swimming, fishing, and shellfishing. And then starting in the 1990s, we identified nutrient impacts to Oyster Pond. We have a road immediately adjacent to us called Oyster Pond Furlong, but underneath that road, there is a 36-inch diameter concrete pipe that conveys stormwater from about 16 acres of upland area. And so what happened here is the existing stormwater pipe was intercepted with a new pipe, which diverts a portion of that stormwater flow into the BMP, where it then travels through an underground gravel bed, which has been designed specifically to retain that water for a certain period of time and allow bacteria that are naturally occurring in that water to remove the nitrogen. That nitrogen is converted to nitrogen gas and goes back up into the atmosphere. And what happens is during a heavy rainfall event, what you see in front of us will actually fill up with water, and then gradually over time that water will percolate down through the system and then discharge back into the natural wetland stream that's just off the site. And then from there it flows down into Oyster Pond.
This Chatham BMP is designed to treat an area of almost 16.9 acres, containing 9.29 acres of impervious surfaces, while the Barnstable BMP is designed to treat approximately 6.9 acres, containing 4.6 acres of impervious area.
The water that was coming out of the outfall into the inner harbor is actually coming from all the way up from our airport area. Some of it is commercial, some of it is home and residential, and some of them are just the quaint downtown area. Whatever we're putting on the ground is getting into the system. This became a park with a wonderful brick pathway that goes through it that connects the different beaches and the waterways of the town so that people could easily move about and enjoy the area. We wanted to preserve that walkway and also the park setting, and the gravel wetland was a perfect inclusion into this environment, and that it had actually a visual location for people to focus on nature and to really learn and be educated about what was going on in our waterways and how we can correct this.
This particular BMP, since we did not have room to size for a larger storm, such as the 1-inch water quality volume, this BMP is sized to treat a 0.3-inch runoff event. And there has been research done in the past by UNH and others that shows as much as 80% of nitrogen within stormwater is present within these small storm events. So really, even though this BMP is relatively small by typical design standards, it really is capturing and removing a lot of the nitrogen from the stormwater.
EPA estimates that if properly maintained, these BMPs will collectively treat about 1.75 million gallons of nitrogen-containing stormwater runoff per year, or about 42% or better of the available nitrogen load from impervious surfaces draining to these BMPs.
And this system is going to help the town of Barnstable relieve some of the issues we have with a marine outfall that's going in the inner harbor, both sediment and also nutrients. It contaminates our shellfish beds, our swimming areas. People come to the Cape not for the mountains, but for our waterways, and we want to protect them.
And unfortunately, here on Cape Cod, real estate is very difficult to come by. In many aspects, the only area that towns have is right along the side of the road. But I think we showed here that we could take a parcel that was originally set aside for conservation, still maintain a lot of conservation aspects of that parcel, but also deal with the nutrient issue.
One of our neighbors is Cape Cod Maritime Museum. They have a STEM program with children, and they're very interested in utilizing this as part of their educational program.
We do want to maintain it as an asset to both the neighborhood and the community while ensuring that the stormwater function continues to meet the goals that EPA and the town have tried to achieve.
EPA will continue to work with the state and its partners in order to understand how systems like these work to remove nutrients in stormwater, not just on the Cape, but in other areas that may be experiencing similar issues. We look forward to implementing innovative approaches that will enhance the resilience of these important and valuable coastal waters and ecosystems.